Okay, we're live.
Hi everybody, and my name's Sam, and this is Ray.
Hey everybody, how you going?
If you do have any requests, just let us know, and we'll have a go at doing them for you.
And it'll be good, because this has been streamed live to the internet.
You might end up on...
You might end up on television. We're going to start with a little Troy Cassidaly song called Trains.
Thank you.
Shadows fans out there? Anyone ever heard of the Shadows?
Yes. Yes.
Hey, that's a this will educate you. You might be a Shadows fan after this one. A little tune called Apache.
Set me free.
back of a $50 note. We're getting $25 charge if we don't know. We've got to get back to the motel, which is about 3 blocks away, so we need fuel for the car.
Where that golden waters blue.
Female Vocalist of the Year.
Yes. Yes.
Got any Disney fans here? No, you've been too young. But when I was young, I used to watch Disneyland, and I used to hear the song. And then when we did our album, someone says, "Oh, that's a yodel." And I thought, never heard it as a yodel. I just know it is.
That someone was me.
Anyway, it's a little tune called "It's a Small World."
I become the diesel dancer.
Any Slim Dusty fans? Sorry, Slim.
Yeah.
Any Slim Dusty fans? No?
No. Dusty fans.
Come on.
No, I won't.
I'll do that one.
Oh, it's pretty traditional, isn't it?
Yeah, we'll do this.
We do a bit of variety here. Everyone knows this one. Whether you love it or whether you don't, everyone knows it.
It's usually the most played song of the Tamworth, or used to be the most played song of the Tamworth Country Music Festival.
Thank you.
rubber tunnel feeding the itch, and sweat and toil waiting for the day. They would pave that road of gold, that would pave their road of gold, and lead them to another grave. Oh, Possum Gully, don't give up your work easily. They picked right through their hearts, sent them out, busted us. Oh, Possum Gully, you don't give up your work easily. Let it pick right through the send them out, lost in us, and each boy to go. We do have albums for sale if anybody wanted to purchase one.
And for the birthday boy down there, if you want one, but you don't feel obliged, it's probably not your cup of tea, but if you want an album, you can come down at some point, pick one out, and you can have one for your birthday.
Who knows, it might inspire you to play guitar.
After here, we're going to go back up to the club and do the country and it's about Sunday with the original showcase.
So, where are you based here?
Inverell.
Inverell. So how much do you charge for doing something like this?
Very expensive. Anywhere between 5 to 10 grand. So every time I'm doing this as part of the organisation. No, average. Well, a lot of the costs is we've got to pay for the internet now.
Yeah.
They charge us.
Yeah.
Close to $1 a megabyte. We're doing 25 and we're going to have the people looking after us today. If you've got a gig, I'm in the area.
Yeah.
I'm happy to employ it for free.
So, just record it.
Just record it.
Yeah, well, how much would you charge for that?
You want
forget
to
about the internet.
No,
about
it's not the DVD, it's just the cost of the DVD. This is only part of it. I mean, before studio set up.
Have you got the cards? No, because what we really need now is we need to get some video stuff done. Just so a proper presence on the internet for agents.
We've got green screens in that studio, so if you wanted to put the lights on here, well, that's not yours. If you wanted to do that, we'd put the truck coming in the background.
Yeah, right. Oh, okay. And you're in Burrell. So that's in the studio, so we can come over there.
Yeah.
All right, we'll keep that in mind, because we're working on a new album, so that's going to be out in August, and we actually want to do some new albums for that album. So if you're interested.
Yeah, I'm actually a movie producer and director. I actually have 3 movies in the international arena at the moment.
Oh, right. So, cool.
I write scripts and that. I'm quite happy if you can work on it, because I do international guest speaking as well too.
Oh, yeah.
It's been in the car heat. We've left it in the car. That's the problem.
So you'll be a friend to say.
That's my son.
So he's teaching you all the tricks, isn't he?
Yeah, he's a fashion bird. Yeah, I'll show you.
Oh, it's an interesting field. I'm an IT engineer, so.
Yeah.
Network engineer, that's what they're for. Sorry?
I'm an audio video engineer.
Yeah, right.
But, I can show you this. I designed, I'm semi retired.
Happy
birthday. You happy birthday?
Yeah.
You want to sing with them over there?
He doesn't want to be on
TV. Oh, they're going to
do it there now, too.
Happy birthday
to you. I said we could do it. His grandfather's name is Sax.
Hooray! Is he really?
Yeah.
Hooray!
Likes your guitar.
Hooray!
Was he? Yeah, so if he wants to help.
Oh, okay.
Before I decided to retire, I used to run a $20 million company in audio video engineering.
Oh, cool.
I designed and built the State Rail communication system for New South Wales.
Did you?
Oh, wow, that's an accomplishment.
So if you go to any train stations, you'll see on the wall the Orange Help Point.
Mm-hmm.
I designed the communications network for that.
Oh, wow.
So if I need an echo chamber or something built, you're the man to come and talk to me.
Eh? I could do that. Not a problem.
Cool. All right, we'll get it back up now. So you've only got, what have you got, half an hour?
We've got 28 minutes.
Yeah, we'll get up and finish off. How are you going?
Down about an hour.
No, I've heard of it.
Yeah,
the only one I do is
if you get enough,
The story? Okay, so the story is, for how many, 2 years, every week I used to send Samantha a bunch of roses, because I lived down the south coast and she lived in Tamworth, and I was chasing her real hard. And anyway, so Sam's dad's always been one for, he goes up to Nunnery, picks a little bunch of flowers and brings them home to Kathy. So it's a bit of a competition in our house now, who can outdo each other with the flowers. But anyway, we went up there one day and we were looking around these ruins, and Peter disappears, and then he comes back with a bunch of flowers. And how he found it, but somewhere in the long grass he found an old school tie. And he had the school tie wrapped around the bunch, and he gave the bunch of flowers to Kathy. And that was the inspiration for this song.
He's always been a little bit that way. We've done a lot of travelling as kids. We had a caravan on the back, four kids, dog, cat, you know, the gypsy style. And you pull up on the side of the road, St. George somewhere, where all the lovely wildflowers are out, and you just pick a little bunch. So he believes that it's the simple things that are the things that count.
He calls me Mr. Shiny.
On the outside, and
when things were different then. We built our world together, with a heart so clear and strong, but that was on the outside.
Because a lot of caravans, but the song was very popular there for some reason.
I think, one stage, in your life, you're always inspiring to do something. Like we were just talking about before, we want to get our caravan and head off. This is a tune. Thank you. is what I have to do. I've made poor choices in the past. Some were good that didn't last. Before the gifts are long away, I thank the Lord every day, healing my soul with my song. Not because I don't love you, not because I found someone new. Chasing dreams is what I have to do. And the wind whispers my name in the shields in the air. Chasing dreams is what I have to do. Not because I don't love you, because I found someone new. Chasing dreams is what I have to do. Chasing dreams, chase your dreams too. Tune I wrote a few years ago. Anyone been out to the Agfest, I think it is, at Gunnedah? Heard about that one, the big Agfest? Anyway, in August, around that time of year, they have the most beautiful display of canola. It's absolutely gorgeous. And just one day I was out there, the canola was out, so I just went home and wrote the song.
It's called Canola Fields.
When you were mine. you.
Thank you.
I know of it, but no, I don't do it. No, it's a lovely song.
It is, yes.
Yeah. I used to do that a lot when I was going through my university degree, but I don't dream in the theatre. Yeah, nice.
This next one, I was lucky enough, a couple of years ago, I recorded an album with Lindsay Waddington and called Watto and Ray, and we put this one on there. Unfortunately, Watto's not here tonight, so I'll have to play his part, but it's an old tune called Mona Lisa from probably the 50s, but this is my version, Mona Lisa.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Like with this?
Thank you.